Hi, and welcome to this new Rush Result 11 tutorial. Today we're gonna see how to link our results to a YouTube video or to a third-party picture platform. First, let's have a look at what we want to achieve. So here's the website of an event, a trail running event that took place in southern France in the mountains of Ardèche. There you see that the results are embedded from myrushworld.com directly in the events website. I can click on the rank to display it. I can then click on the participant to display his detailed results as well as his certificates. So if I click on his bib number, for example, that's the bib that the participant was wearing on that day, and he could scan the QR code after crossing the line to check the results live online. And on top of this, there's a YouTube link on top that you can click to see this precise participant's finishing. There he comes in a couple of seconds. All right. You can also click picture link to display this participant's picture taken on the course. Okay, this is what we want to do. Now, this is how we are going to do it. So, first, we need to shoot the video, cut it and publish it. Second, we will have to link the results to the video and pictures. And third, we'll have to publish the results and embed them in the events website. To shoot the video, you will need, of course, a timing system to record the times. And you will also need a video, like video camera, like a GoPro, shooting the finish line continuously. So here comes the first participant shortly after 11 a.m. and we will shoot the video until the last participant has crossed the line. Once the video is complete, we will cut it so that the first participant crosses the line after 10 seconds. And we will publish it online on a video platform like YouTube. So what you see here in black is the standard part of the video link. And then in red, you have a code that is actually the ID of the video. So what we want to do is create a video link user-defined field. And as the video code is the one part that changes, we will create two user-defined fields. One video code, where we will only paste the code, and one video link with the standard URL and the video code parameter. Now we know that the first participant crosses the line 10 seconds after the video starts. So that's automatic. Now, as we want to create a link for all the participants that starts 10 seconds before they cross the line, we need to calculate the gap to the first participant and use that as an offset to start the video. So for the second participant, for example, this gap equals 3 minutes 32. That's 212 seconds. So how do we calculate this offset? In my event file, the finish detection is time 14. I will then calculate rounded time 14 for this participant, minus 11 hours and 49 seconds. That's the finish time of day of the first participant. This will give me this offset that I will add at the end of the video link user-defined field after a hash and T equals. That's the part of the link that tells YouTube to start from a given time. Okay, but actually, being a timer, you need to reduce the steps as much as possible. So, if I don't want to look for the finish time of the first participant every time, I can calculate it automatically and ask the software to fetch it. So, here I created another rank number 4. That's going to be my YouTube rank. I will explain later why I had to create an extra rank and I didn't simply use my overall rank. So, considering rank 4, I will take rounded time 14 of the first participant. And then the software will calculate that automatically. So that next time I simply need to change the video code and the video offset will be calculated automatically. For the photo link, we apply the same principle, but it's much simpler because we can simply paste that on the bib. Okay, so I will host my pictures on my website. And I will create a page that automatically fetches the picture of the participant based on his bib number. So that was for the theory. Now let's go to the practice and have a look at the event file. So here's my event file, just a few words of introduction before we go into details. That's a 15 km and 30 km trail run. The 30K starts at 9 a.m. and the 15 km starts at 10. So that we will have participants crossing the finish line, participants from both contests crossing the finish line at the same time. Okay, let's have a quick look at the results. I'm simply recording times at split 1, 2, and 3 and at the finish. Then here's why I had to create a YouTube rank and I couldn't just use my total rank because in the total rank there's a contest groupings. So it will create two sub ranks for each contest. But remember that I have participants from both contests crossing the line simultaneously. So that's why I just created this YouTube rank without a contest grouping. Now let's go to the most important part. Here's our user-defined field and functions section. Here's my photo link. Same as in the PDF I just showed you. Then my video offset, video code that I can just update on so next time around when I time this event again. Then my video link. I added a video link to function, which you can actually use if you want the video to start from, so to start full screen directly. And to finish also automatically after the participant has crossed the line. The only inconvenience of this is that it doesn't work on mobile devices then. So I would rather use this, which is a bit simpler, but works with all kind of devices. Okay, now that I have my fields, I need to use them in an output list. So here is how. I go to the details, that's where I have my links. So the links are actually on an image. Here's how I can add an image. I just open quotes and brackets. I type img and 2 points. Then the URL of the image hosted on my server. And then I can add a height parameter so that I can control the size. And then I close the brackets and the quotes. Now to add the link to the image, I just click on these two arrows on the right, and in the field HTML link as expression, I will add my video link field. between brackets. Okay, same for the pictures. All right, let's have a quick look at the certificate set. On the bib, you can go to the layout. And if I have a look at the back of the picture, here's my QR code. And you can see that the QR code links to a certificate that's stored online, and also it's bib dependent. So each participant can scan his own bib and access his own certificate directly. Right, now that we have designed our results and certificates, we need to publish them online. So I go to marashall.com. I tick both boxes to activate the page on marashall.com. Then in the publishing section, I select the participants list, the result list that I want to publish. And for each list, I can select a details list. So I will select my details. Then I can go to certificates and select the certificates that I want to publish for each participant. Okay. My results are then available online on our platform, my.rational.com. Now, if I want to embed them directly in my website, which I do, I go directly to marashall.com. Then in basic settings, I will find the website integration settings. And I can simply copy this code, actually this one for the results. I can copy this and paste it in the code of my website. And this is the end. I hope that you enjoyed watching this tutorial, and stay tuned for more information soon.